Right. We're live. It's on. Okay, let's see. Yes. So today I have an interesting class planned. As you can see, the setup of the class is different. Too for people to get online. Okay. So an introduction for those who are already online while people are channeling in. Today we have an interesting class. That's why the setting is a bit different. Actually, we're not going to be on our feet at all. Today we're focusing on deep core and will be a challenge, I guess, to do a class with all the typical sun salutations and all that jazz. But this is a Raja Yoga class. So it's a class about the royal path of yoga. It's different techniques that help us to attain yoga, this state of separation from the illusions, this state where we calm our mind down and we're not basically distracted by the stories in our head. We're not being imposed any reality. We're actually able to live life fully in a healthy and happy way, where we accept some things that we cannot change, such as the fact that right now we're meant to be stuck at home, so we accept that. We don't allow ourselves to suffer. Yes, there's difficulties in life, there's pain in life, but at the same time, suffering is optional. You don't have to keep going back to that. Buddha said that the reason why he does not feel he does not suffer as much is because other people feel 1,000 arrows when one arrow hits them, whereas he chooses to just feel one arrow. So right now we're at home, okay, not the easiest pill to swallow, but we'll swallow it and we'll make the most of it. Today's practice is about tapas. Tapas is the fire, it's the digestive fire of the body that allows the body to digest what's going on mentally, physically, emotionally, spiritually. And on the other side of this fire, there's ojas. So through that fire, we get to polish ourselves. We get to burn out anything that's not us, all of those stories, all of those distractions, so that we can get that ojas, that bright light where everything about us is just shining, and we have that shining personality that shines through, and we can simply be ourselves and enjoy life. That's what we're doing today. Fire. We'll use the Agni, so the digestive fire of the body, to get rid of any impurities in the body. We'll do different interesting practices. And as I said already, for those who are just channeling in, there's no standing poses today, which is a relief for me because I mean that's my weak point. Today we're working with that fire, and then from tomorrow again we'll get back to all of the sun salutations and all of that interesting part of the practice. Okay, we'll start lying down. Lie on your back and bring your hands to your tummy. Feel the support of the ground under your body. Relax the muscles of your face, relax your eyebrows, your jaw. And have your hands on top of your belly button, just as a reminder that that's where you want to direct your full attention today. Notice if there's any more stiffness in the body that's easily going to be get rid of, and just get rid of it. One more time, relax your eyebrows, relax your jaw. If you want, you can fake a sigh. So open your mouth wide. And just sigh it out, relax your face, relax your shoulders down, your shoulder blades. Allow them to be pulled down by gravity. Allow your feet to splay out so that you're not holding up the feet, so that you're not using the muscles of the legs. And keep your eyes closed or very softly gazing at a fixed point. Bring that idea, that vision of fire at the center of your belly. If you're a visual person, you can visualize a bright fire there. A fire that purifies your whole body, your whole being. If you're not as visual, you can feel the warmth, the vibration, the tingling sensation of the flames. And if you're more of an audio type, you can listen to how the fire just burns without burning out, just there to warm you up, to make you feel that sense of family, home. Welcome home, welcome to the practice. Beautiful. We'll bring our hands a bit further away from the belly button so that they're resting on the lower ribs, the lower part of the rib cage, the floating ribs. Again, no pressure right now, no stiffness and no engagements. Notice how the ribcage flares out with every natural inhale. How it comes back in with every natural exhale. See if you can relax the ribcage a bit more. If you can relax the diaphragm a bit more, you can relax the shoulder blades a bit more. Keep coming back to that sensation of the fire burning in the body. And remember that it's a friendly fire. It's there to keep you warm, keep you safe, and keep you strong. Manipura, the energetic center at the navel center, Manipura, it actually means the city of gems, the city of jewels in the body. That's where all the abundance lies. If you want access to that abundance, all you need to is to bring all of your awareness to that point behind your belly button and feel that strength there, feel that confidence, that innate confidence that lies within. The next time that your ribcage closes in, you'll use some force with the hands to hold the ribcage closed as you inhale. If you're not used to this, it might feel like a strain, but do your best so that you exhale the ribs in naturally, and then you use some force with the hands to push the ribs in
and hold them in as you inhale. Exhale, feel how the lower belly comes in, how the rib cage comes in. And inhale, keep the rib cage closed. Feel like you're picking up the back bottom ribs, reaching them up towards the chest. Okay, we're starting to wake up that fire. So exhale, pull the lower belly all the way down to the spine, the rib cage in. And then as you inhale, hold the lower belly down into the spine and pick it up towards the lower ribs. Pick up the lower ribs towards the chest. Exhale, release the arms by the sides, but keep the engagement. So keep the lower belly coming in, reaching up towards the heart. Keep the rib cage in, reaching up towards the shoulders. Exhale, lower belly in. Press your lower back to the ground and bring your arms overhead. So we'll bring the arms overhead, we'll interlace the fingers and we'll push the palms out. Now from here, we'll actually bring the feet together and flex the feet. And we want to go for the Agnisara engagement here. So we want to find Uddiyana Bandha by pulling the lower belly in and pushing it towards the spine and then lifting it up towards the chin. Straighten the arms, push away through the palms. Exhale, pull lower belly in and up. And then push away further. Keep the lower belly in, the ribs up. Okay, we'll hold the breath out. So exhale all the air out through the mouth. Pull lower belly in and lift it up. Imagine a vacuum under the rib cage. And then soften the belly, relax and inhale. And again, exhale, push away through the palms, let all the air out through the mouth. Hold the breath and imagine that you're inhaling without inhaling. Pull everything in and lift it up towards the chest. First relax and then inhale. We'll do it three more times. So do your best to flex the feet, push away through the heels, flex the palms, push away through the palms. Lower belly in, and once all the air is out, pick everything up. Relax, two more times. Inhale. And exhale, flex feet, push away through the palms, let all the air out. Keep the lower belly in, and squeeze it up. Push the lower back to the ground. Reach the palms further away. Then relax, inhale. Last one, exhale. Push away through the palms, push away through the feet, pull the belly in, let all the air out, and then pick the belly towards the chest. Pick up the rib cage. Keep pushing away through the palms, feel the vacuum at the center of the navel. And then relax, and inhale. Exhale, inhale into the belly. Now fill the belly with air. Open the mouth side out. Bring your arms by the sides. Inhale into the belly, pick up the belly button, reach the sides of the belly sideways, really expand the belly, push the lower back to the ground, and then open the mouth, exhale. Press your palms on the ground. Bring your heels together and open up the feet just like ballerinas or ballerinos. So find your position 1, your first position, by opening up your feet, splaying the feet out, but keeping the heels together. Keep the legs straight. Squeeze your glutes. So feel that squeeze from the glutes in order to lift the pelvic floor up. Remember the Mula Bandha we were working on in the grounding session. So you want that lift from the perineum or the cervix for the women. And then pull the lower belly in, lift it up, keep the rib cage in and lift it up. Hold the engagements. Press down into the ground with your palms. Pick up the chest, bring the chin in, long neck. Pull the shoulder blades down the back. From here, we'll exhale, lower belly in, press the lower back onto the ground, keep the heels together, the legs straight, and then inhale, pick up the legs. Keep the feet laying out, just like ballerinas. Keep the lower belly in, send the sit bones away from you. Push the lower back to the ground, inhale, open up the feet a bit more, and exhale, move the feet to a 45 degree angle. Keep the lower belly in as you inhale, and exhale, bring the feet just hovering off the ground, a couple of centimeters. Inhale, keep the lower back to the ground, and exhale, bring the feet down, relax. Okay, we'll go one more time. Now really bring your awareness to your navel center, to your deep core. Bring your palms to the ground, pick up the chest, bring the chin in. Open up the feet, just like ballerinas, straighten the legs. So try to press the knees together as an indication that you want the knees to be straight, the legs to be straight. Squeeze your glutes. Imagine that you're holding on to a $500 bill with your glutes. Pull the belly in, squeeze the glutes, push the lower back to the ground. All your awareness at the fire, at the belly. Inhale the legs up, all the way up. And then exhale, 45 degree angles. Keep the lower belly in, press lower back to the ground. Stay here as you exhale. Open up the feet a bit more, straighten the legs, squeeze the glutes, inhale. And exhale, bring the feet just hovering off the ground. Pull belly in, inhale. And exhale, stay here, lower back down. Inhale, squeeze the glutes. And exhale, stay here. Okay, we're coming up, inhale, 45 degrees. And exhale, press lower back to the ground, pull lower belly in, lift it towards the chest, inhale, and exhale, press palms onto the ground, squeeze the glutes, inhale, and exhale, stay here, inhale, come up, 90 degree angles, exhale, 45, inhale, 45, exhale, just hovering off the ground, inhale here, and exhale, release, bring your hands to your belly again. Close your eyes, relax your eyebrows, relax your jaw. Keep coming back to that idea of the fire. The feeling, the sound, the mere thought of it. According to the Yoga Sutras, the ancient text about what yoga is. In order to attain this state of yoga, this state of enlightenment, there's three steps, and these three steps are also then put into the eight limbs. Tapas, the fire, the discipline. Svadhyaya, self-study and study of the scriptures, and then complete surrender.
Ishvara Grandana.
So today we're working with these ideas of fire in order to find out more about ourselves, our strengths, and then in order to trust completely. Trust that we're at the right place and we can simply let go and just give our best to the current moment. Just by giving your heart and soul to what's happening right now, you can enjoy the present without any worries about the past, about the future, and just trusting that the best is already happening. Bend your knees and bring your knees to your chest. Hug your knees, and you want to press up with the knees and press down with the hands to lengthen the lower back. Push your thighs a bit closer to the lower belly and bring your head up to the knees. Pull the shoulder blades down the back. We'll go for bicycle abdominals. So bring your knees over the hips. Flex the feet and bring your hands behind the back, elbows in. From here, we'll pick up our upper back, but keep the lower back on the ground and pull the shoulder blades down the back while they're still off the ground. Inhale here, flex the feet, and exhale, reach the right leg out and bring your elbows towards the left thigh. Inhale, come back to center, keep the lower belly in, and exhale, straighten the other leg, bring elbows towards the thigh. Inhale, come up, keep the lower belly in, and exhale, bring the leg out, pick up the tailbone and bring the elbows closer to the left thigh. Inhale, come back to center, keep the lower belly down, and exhale, push away through the left foot, pick up the tailbone, so pick up your butt and bring your chest closer to the right thigh. Two more on each side. Inhale, back to center, keep the lower belly in, and exhale, right leg out, straighten the leg, pick up the butt and bring the elbows to the thigh. Inhale, back to center, hopefully you're feeling that fire. Exhale, leg out, really pick up the tailbone, so uncurl the tailbone and push back. Inhale, come back to center, curling the tailbone, I meant to say. And exhale, right leg out, so curl in the tailbone, pick up the tailbone, bring the elbows to the left thigh. Last one, inhale back to center, stay with it. And exhale, left leg out, pick up the tailbone, bring elbows to the thigh, keep the lower belly down. And inhale, come back, bring the feet down. Straighten your arms, reach away through the arms, keep the belly in, and then we'll do 5 sit-ups. So pull belly in, come forward, press down into the feet to come up and reach up, and then belly in and come back. So in, up, in, and come back. 3 more, up, in, and come back. 2 more, keep the lower belly in. Keep pressing down into the feet. Last one. And then come up and stay. Open up the feet, bring the hips back. Now you uncurl the tailbone, pick up the chest. We'll stay high. If your knees are higher, that's normal. My hips are abnormal. So send your sit bones back, pull the lower belly in, pick it up. Pick up the chest, relax your eyebrows, relax your jaw. Have a sense of pushing the outer feet together, the heels together, and sending the hips into the pelvis. From that sense of grounding, feel the pelvic floor lifting, pull the lower belly and lift it up, and pick up the chest with the rib cage in and lifting up. Relax the eyebrows, relax the jaw. We'll go for Bhastrika, bellows breath. If you've never tried it before, it's just forceful inhalations and forceful exhalations. It might make you feel dizzy, so take it easy. You can go slower than I go. The idea is to pick up the pace so that it's quite fast. But as I said, you can go slow. So keep sitting up tall and curl the tailbone back. Bring all your awareness to the belly. If you want to, place the hands on the belly, because what you want is to keep pumping the belly with air. So you're inhaling and you're filling the belly with air, and exhaling and you're emptying the belly out of air. It's forceful actions at the belly. So when you're ready, exhale all the air out, all the awareness at the belly, at that fire, and then begin through the mouth. Seven, six, five, four, three, two, exhale, all the air out. Pull belly in, chin in, shoulders back, shoulder blades down, and round down. Keep the lower belly in and keep your focus at the belly. Svadhyaya, self-study, watch what's coming up. And from here, we'll keep the chin on the chest as we pick up the body so that we don't get too dizzy.
Remember, if it's the first time you're doing it, it's normal to get a bit dizzy. Take it easy, take it slow, or take a break. Have your awareness at the belly and breathe normally. Otherwise, second round through the nose. So pick up the chest, shoulders back, shoulder blades down, and curl the tailbone back. Strong body. Press heels together, send hips into the hip sockets, pick up the lower belly, exhale through the nose or repeat through the mouth. Seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Exhale all the air out.
Chin in, round the back, shoulder blades down. Keep your chin stuck onto the chest. And slowly uncurl up.
Remember to keep the deep core muscles working. If you're not working with the deep core, then you're not doing anything and you're just fooling yourself. So don't cheat. Use your hands to bring the knees in. One shin on in front of the other and bring the feet as close to the hips as possible. Uncurl the tailbone back again, so feel like you're sitting in at the very bottom of the pelvis, so almost on your genitals. And then keep the feet close to the genitals, keep the knees close to the chest. Press down onto the hands and push up. Keep pressing down into the sit bones, down into the feet, keep the chest part, relax the face, relax the chin. If you don't feel anything at the deep core, then press harder, press into the hands, press down into the sit bones and pick up the lower belly and breathe. Remember the action with the rib cage. So exhale the ribs in and inhale, pick up the back bottom ribs, hold them up. Relax the eyebrows, relax the jaw. Keep the knees close to the chest, the feet close to the hips. Press into the hands, pick up the chest a bit more. And from that place, exhale, relax the legs. We'll go one more time. Maybe this time we'll lift up, maybe we'll do the same. So it's up to you to repeat what we did or to go for a lift up. Knees in, feet in. Again, you can use your fingers to uncurl the tailbone back so that you find this anterior pelvic tilt. You want to anteriorly tilt the pelvis, not posteriorly, but anteriorly, so that you're actually sitting at the very front of your pelvis, front as in from where you are right now. Keep your knees in, your feet in, hands by your sides. Press, pick up the chest. Again, stay here if you need to, or push to lift the hips up, maybe one foot up, maybe both. Five breaths. Keep the knees close to the chest. Four breaths. Keep the lower belly in, the ribs in and up. Three breaths. Keep pressing into the hands wherever you are, straight arms, two breaths. Last breath. Without losing the engagements, come down very slowly, chest up, release your legs. Pick up the chest, relax the eyebrows, relax the jaw. Three lion's breaths. So inhale and round the back. Exhale, arch the back, stick the tongue out, make a hissing sound. Two more. Good. Sit tall, relax the eyebrows, relax the jaw. Keep observing. Keep a distance from your body, from your mind, from your feelings. And study them to get feedback about what this body is about, what this mind is about, what these feelings are about. When you can pick and choose what you believe and where you're going to invest your energy, then you're picking and choosing what you want your reality to be. Your external reality is just a reflection of the internal reality. Self-study. Study yourself, and you'll know the word. Or at least your word, your reality. Good. Okay. We'll come to a kneeling position, and we'll try another pickup. So feet in, knees in. We'll round the back. So pull the shoulders back, shoulder blades down, round down, and bring your hands to the ground. Push into the hands, really push strongly. And then from here, press the tops of the feet down to lift the knees up. And then maybe keep pressing the tops of the feet down and lift the hips all the way up, knees to the chest. Four, five. Four, keep pressing the hands down. Four, three, lower belly in and forward. Four, two, and one, very slowly come down. Maybe it does not look like what I'm doing, maybe you're doing it better. So work with what you have. Maybe you're just here and you're pushing and you're feeling that fire. That's more than enough. Then sit still and again, observe your reality, observe what you're telling yourself, what you're thinking. Maybe you want to quit. Maybe you're thinking about what's going to happen after this class. Maybe you don't like what's happening right now. Just watch it and detach. What's going on? Okay. One more time. This time we'll also lift the feet up. If you visualize it, then all the engagements will happen. Maybe you won't lift up, but it's as if you are lifting up. So hands on the ground. Press down, pull the shoulders all the way back, chin in, press down, lift the knees, maybe lift the feet, four, five, press into the hands, four, four, keep the lower belly in, four, three, knees to chest, feet to hips, four, two, and one, calm down, relax. Good. Okay, hopping through. Again, maybe you won't be hopping through today, but you will have the engagements. So press down into the hands and bring the feet back. Downward facing dog. Take this hand as an opportunity to extend the whole body. So press into the hands, widen the shoulder blades and curl the tailbone up. You can keep the knees bent to lengthen the lower back a bit more and then maybe straighten the legs, send the heels back. From here, we gaze forward, we push into the hands. We bend the knees and we'll hop to bring the feet in between the hands. So we're not hopping through yet. So push into the hands, pull the belly in, knees close to the chest, and then we'll think of the hips coming up first so that the feet can come in between the hands. Because if the hips just come forward, what will happen is that you end up here with the knees. What you want is feet on the ground. So think of the hips coming up, keep the knees close to the chest, and cross the shins on the way. So inhale, push away, exhale, pull the belly in, thighs close to the belly, and then push and bring the feet in between the hands. Good, try it again. So push away, widen the shoulder blades, gaze forward, bend the knees, exhale, hold the exhale, and kick up and cross. One more time, do it the other way, you're always crossing the same way. So bend the knees, gaze forward, widen the shoulder blades, push and hop. Good. Okay, one more time. Maybe you'll hop through or maybe you'll just do the same thing. So I'll do the same thing. Pull the belly in, push into the hands, gaze forward and kick up. And then from here, you walk through. Make sure that your feet are flexed and curl the tailbone. Pull the belly in, lift up, pick up the chest. And then from here, bring the chin in, round the back, pull the shoulder blades down, and bring head to knee. Keep the feet flexed, feel the thighs working, send the sit bones back, and for, like, by all means,
Pull lower belly in and lift it up. Find a distance from your pubis to the belly button. If you feel any discomfort in the neck, it's an indication that you're not pulling the shoulders back and the shoulder blades down. Really lengthen the neck. Keep the chin in. This must feel like a relief for the neck. Of course, maybe you're pushing yourself too much, so maybe come a bit out of it. Pain is always a good ally. It tells us what we're doing and where we should be backing off. Okay, inhale and come up.
We'll round in, we'll feel that fire, we'll push, and we want to lift the hips up and back. So push, shoulders back, shoulder blades down, flex the feet, chin in, round the back, and then exhale there out, pick up the lower belly, push into the hands, pick up the hips, then move them back. 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Slowly come down. One more time. This time we'll lift the feet up. All right, shoulders back, shoulder blades down. Again, keep visualizing it, or maybe you're already doing it. Okay, flex the feet. As a reminder to use the quads. You want to feel like the front of the body is really squeezing so that the back of the body is able to really extend and fly up. So push into the hands, shoulders back, shoulder blades down, chin in, find that fire. Press into the hands and push. Hips up, hips back, and maybe feet up. 4, 5. Press into the hands. 4, 4. Lower belly in and up. 4, 3. Try it again if you fell. 4, 2. And 1. Slowly come down. Bring the knees in. Cross the shins and come to a comfortable sit. And curl the tailbone back. Pick up the chest. Open up the palms. Push the palms away and pull the fingers back. So you want this open palm position where you're pulling the fingers back. Really open the arms wide. Shoulders back, shoulder blades down. Pick up the back of the skull. We'll go for Kapalabhati, the cleansing breath, skull shining breath. Focus at the lower belly, but keep pushing the palms away, pulling the fingers back to open up your heart. But it's just the belly that's moving. So it's quick, short, sharp, exhale breath through the belly. The inhale is automatic. We'll do a first one through the mouth, and it's as if you're blowing a candle. So you don't have to think of inhaling. It happens on its own accord. Push away through the palms, shoulders back, shoulder blades down. Reach up through the back of the skull. Press down through the sit bones. Sit in front of the sit bones. Exhale. Through the mouth. Inhale half a breath and begin pumping the belly. Top. Shoulders back, shoulder blades down, bring the chin in. Chin up, exhale through the nose. One more breath. If you need to, bring the arms down and then bring them up again. We want to push away through the palms and pull back through the fingertips. Inhale into the belly and exhale. Again, through the mouth or through the nose. I'll do it through the nose this time, the traditional way. Inhale, half a breath into the belly, into the fire, and then start pumping that fire. Sharp, sharp, quick, exhale, breaths. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, all there out. Inhale. Pick up the pelvic floor, bring the chin in, push away through the palms, pull back through the fingers, relax the eyebrows, the jaw, hold the breath. Visualize a bright light at the center of the chest. Bring the chin up, relax pelvic floor, exhale through the nose. Inhale, bring the arms up, reach up, interlace fingers, push up and exhale, arms to your belly. Breathe into the belly. Breathe out. Again, relax the muscles of the face, concentrate at the navel center, inhale. Open the mouth and cleanse it up. One more time. Fill the belly with air, front, sides, back of the belly, fill with air. And open the mouth, let it go. Carefully bring the knees in. Knees close to the chest, feet close to the hips. We're going to kick back or walk back. So push into the hands. Maybe you can lift the hips. Maybe you also lift the legs. If you can lift everything, you can push back into a low push-up. If you cannot lift everything, then lift the hips, press into the hands, keep the knees close to the chest, and walk back. Come to a low push-up. Maybe you need to bring the knees to the ground, and then slowly come down. Form fists with the hands, and place the fists under the belly. So right in front of the belly button. Lie on top of the two fists. Keep your legs hip distance apart. Relax the heels out. Pull the shoulders up, shoulder blades back, chin forward. If it's too much to have the chin forward, then forehead on the ground. Breathe onto the hands. Every exhale, feel the navel coming closer to the spine. Inhale, push into the hands. And exhale, feel the fists coming closer to the spine. Keep breathing in this way. You can breathe out through the mouth or through the nose. Make sure your eyebrows are relaxed, your jaw is relaxed, your inner ears are relaxed. Make sure your shoulder blades are relaxed towards the sacrum. Everything is relaxed really, and you want to feel that fire right where you're pressing with the fists. Three more breaths here. Make your inhales as full as possible. Really push the belly onto your hands. Really widen the belly to the sides. And then make your exhales as complete as possible, emptying the lungs of air, bringing the fists closer to the spine. Your spine is actually quite thick. So don't think of your spine as a thin column, it's quite thick. So keep pushing with the fists to access the spine. One last time, inhale. Inhale a full breath into the belly. Push the belly down sideways. Even feel the lower back coming up. And then open the mouth and exhale completely. Hold the breath out for a second. Relax and inhale. Bring your arms to the sides. You can bring your head to one side if it feels more relaxed that way. And breathe normally into the belly. Feel what comes up. Don't hide from it. Listen, feel, watch, accept, surrender. We'll finish our practice with
a couple of locust poses just to counter all the force. So bring your chin forward, cross your feet, so just one foot on top of the other, keep your legs straight, point the feet, and then interlace your hands. Bring your chin forward, reach your shoulders up towards the sky, and then push your shoulders back using your hands. Inhale the chin forward, chin up, and exhale the arms up and push back. Inhale, lift up a bit higher through the chin and lift the legs up. Exhale, pull the lower belly in and forward. Switch the cross of the fingers. So opposite thumb on top, opposite finger at the bottom, and then switch the legs. So opposite foot on top. We come to the side for this one. So it's the same. Eye forward, chin, arms up, arms back, chin forward, chin up, legs up. Use your glutes and suck the belly in, reach it up. 4, 5. Lower ribs in and reach them up. 4, 4. Legs higher up, arms higher up. 4, 3. Hands back, chin forward. 4, 2. Take a deep breath here. And exhale, lower, keeping that length. Okay. Bring your hands into fists one more time and lay on top of them. Pull the shoulders back, bring your chin down or your head to the opposite side if you laid it on the one side. No forcefulness anymore, just your natural breath. Relax your shoulders down, relax your elbows down, relax the muscles of your face. Relax your glutes, relax the pelvic floor, one by one, the thin layers of muscle at the pelvis. Relax your diaphragm, allow your breath to be natural. And then roll slightly to one side to remove one arm, roll to the other to remove the other arm. You can stay here, lying on your belly. You can bring the forearms under the forehead if it makes it more comfortable for you to have the forehead on the forearms. Or you can turn around and lie on your side or lie face up. Shavasana, corpse pose. Completely abandon any engagements. Relax your face, relax arms, legs. And relax your awareness at the fire behind the belly button. Stay still, surrender to stillness, and surrender to the wisdom that lies within that fire. Accept the abundance that lies within. The wisdom that lies within, the power that lies within. And for the next few moments, we want to lay here, motionless, completely open to any feelings, any insights, anything that might come up. Also completely open to the possibility that nothing might come up, which is equally beautiful because it's an opportunity for your body to rest and digest life. Lie in stillness and relax your awareness on the fire. Relax.
Thank you.
choose happiness. I am free. Gently, start bringing your awareness back to your body, back to the power of your body. Your breath and the energy that lies behind your breath. Breathe into the belly. Breathe in, push the belly button up, feel the. Breathe out and surrender to that fire. That fire with your fingers, with your toes. Start moving fingers, toes, start moving head from side to side. And starting from that place of abundance, confidence, power, start moving the whole body, stretching the whole body. Position in 1 minute, so make the most of this minute. Move and stretch and wake up. Can find that confidence in your seat, that long lower back. Relax your shoulder blades down and reach the back of your skull up. Relax the muscles of your face and breathe into the belly. Conquering the whole of your body. Again, inhale into the and exhale, send that warmth, that strength to the to every single cell of your body. One more time, inhale into the belly, fill the belly with air and access that fire. And exhale through the nose, feel that fire going and rejuvenating the whole body. From that place of strength, inhale your arms up, reach up, straight up. And exhale your hands to heart center, allow your head to bow down. Thank you for who you are, thank you for your strength, your resilience, your conviction, and your to that you choose. Your life is in your hands. We accept what we cannot change, and we have every right and courage and confidence and strength to change everything that we can change. Thank you.
The light, the fire within me honors and celebrates the light and fire within you. Namaste. This was our strength, deep core strength, fire tapas session. Hope you had more of an insight of who you are and your strength and your confidence. And I hope you had an opportunity to study yourself a bit more, to learn a bit more about yourself so that you can find that trust to surrender, to enjoy life for what it is, and to trust that the best is already happening and there's a bright future ahead.
Thank you again. And if you have any comments, questions, suggestions, let me know. Tomorrow we're probably doing our vinyasa session from the Yoga One Marina account. I'll be posting on Instagram, so stay tuned. And if you have any special suggestions, you let me know. Take care.